Well, well, well. Who knew that winning a single game could feel like winning the NBA championship? The Lakers donned their party hats, blew up some balloons, and probably even ordered a confetti cannon to celebrate JJ's very first coaching victory. Honestly, if this is the energy they bring for a single W, I can only imagine the parade they must have planned for a playoff berth. Forget the trophy, just give JJ a piñata and a confetti explosion. You gotta love the Lakers' commitment to ensuring everyone knows this was the big one. I mean, come on. They popped an entire year's worth of champagne for a coach's initial win. Meanwhile, fans everywhere are just sitting there wondering how many extravagant dinners or half-price burgers it took to line up this celebration. For a minute, it felt like they were throwing a birthday bash more than acknowledging a basketball win. Hope someone shared the cake. Now let's talk about the sparkling emotional support provided by the players. Throwing comments like, "We did it, coach," with faces that could only be rivaled by four-year-olds getting a gold star for the first time. It's like they just discovered the joy of bubble wrap, bubbly, messy, and utterly ecstatic. Who needs a motivational speech with confetti-filled hugs to celebrate this monumental milestone? I say, let's just bring out the karaoke machine next. Or maybe it was just the wild idea that winning one game can suddenly turn you into the next Phil Jackson. Perhaps they're hoping the joy will be infectious enough to help the rest of the season just fall into place. Guys, it was one game, not a blessing from the basketball gods. Come on, Lakers, shouldn't we save the real magic for the finals? Or are we going to be assigning a gold star to every W we get from now on? And you know what makes it all even funnier? The reporters standing by, wide-eyed and ready to turn this one victory into an ESPN documentary series. The Lakers Chronicles, the journey of JJ Redick's first win, sounds like a bestseller just waiting to happen. They might even provide a behind-the-scenes look at JJ reading bedtime stories to the players to ensure they get their rest before the next game. Now that would be entertaining television. Meanwhile, I'm here living my regular life, chugging coffee and trying not to set fire to breakfast, and the Lakers are out there living it up like they just landed on the moon. I mean, coming down to reality might reveal a splash of cold water, especially when the next opponent rolls into town looking to rain on this victory parade. Grab your raincoats, Lakers, because you may need them after the storm of reality hits. But let's clarify the ultimate question. Is this jubilation justified? Or are they just soft launching JJ's reign like he's about to sell out Madison Square Garden? Are we prepared for another winless revelry if the streak doesn't hold? Or are they just getting warmed up for the national celebration of Laker coaches on a one-win schedule? Dazzling or delusional? What's your take on this basketball jubilation? Like and subscribe, please.